Solis.
So what is Novel Horizon?
Novel Horizon is an original English light novel publishing company where we get American authors and we find the best illustrators from around the world to do the artwork for them. And then they're published in Dallas, Texas.
How long have you guys been in operation?
We first opened our doors in August 2020, right in the middle of the whole craziness of the year.
Man, it's a rough time to start. How's that going for you guys so far?
You know, it's been 50-50 because with people all locked up in their homes, more people were open to reading books. So a lot of people who wouldn't be into reading started picking up books, started, you know, killing time and things like that. So it ended up really working out for us in some ways. But since we didn't have conventions to go to at the time, we couldn't do what we do now, is sort of spread our presence out. You let people know who we are and that we actually exist.
So how many books do you have in publications currently?
Currently we only have 5 books in publication. We have our Just Say You Won't Let Go, Rise of the Hunters, Echoes of Hysteria, Azure Wing, and our newest release, Seven Star. We used to have one more series, had 2 books in it in publication, but that one's no longer in active print.
So what does it take to catch the eye of Novel Horizons and get your work out there and try to get published?
We actually have a section on our website, novelhorizons.com, where you can go and we have our little rules and the things we look for in submissions, and you can submit it to novelhorizonspublishers@gmail.com, and then we'll read through that and we'll let you know whether, you know, we think it's something that we can work with or if it's a genre we're looking for right now. Because what we're really looking to do right now is fill out our genres so we're not so skewed in one area. So when we opened up, we had a lot of fantasy, but we were missing sci-fi or like horror or romance. And that's where we ended up picking up this sci-fi series, and we have this romance series. And then this one's more school life. So we're trying to right now get that whole circle of balance. So as far as catching our eye, we just look for a good quality story after like considering the genre stuff. And then we're also thinking of hosting a competition soon to make things a little bit more community-orientated, more fun, things like that.
So when it comes to sending in a request, do you want finished books or can people send in like an unfinished draft and work with you on pushing that forward?
So we take both. We take finished manuscripts for our first volume, and then we also take partial manuscripts. And then for both of those, we ask that the author provides us a vision of where they see the series going. An overview of kind of where it's beginning, where the middle is, and where it's going to end. And then sometimes character biographies. Sometimes we get questions like, oh, do we need to provide artwork with our submissions? And the answer is usually no, or it's always no. Because the artwork is taken care of by us. So we find illustrators and that would best, whose style best matches the spirit of the manuscript. And then we work with the author to kind of create that good blend where they're happy with the final result of their work.
So is this international? Is it just simply for a Western audience? Since you're an English novel, light novel publisher, do you take work from other parts of the country and translate them?
We only accept manuscripts that are in English currently, so we don't translate anything into English. But the author can be anywhere from around the world as long as their English writing is, you know, at the right level. Because there are sometimes where we get submissions for manuscripts, but you can tell that they're not a native English speaker. And what that ends up doing is driving up costs a lot, because we have to end up going through and communicating a lot with the author on their intentions and what they're really trying to do. So it's like writing a whole manuscript from scratch, and then the editors have a nightmare with it too.
So far from your original 5 that you have right now, it seems very anime-esque. Mm-hmm. Do you only accept those kind of stories, or do you accept more indigenous or more what is it? Not bibliography. Bibliography, like just self stories.
You mean like biographies, as in like someone talking about their own history?
Yeah.
Well, right now we're not really doing nonfiction. We only do fiction books. But as far as like them being anime, as long as the story is good, we're willing to publish it. Because when it comes down to anime, it kind of stops with the art style we go for. So the stories we publish don't have to follow the normal anime tropes that you see a lot in the animation culture. Like a lot, some of these titles don't really follow those tropes. Echoes of Hysteria doesn't follow that trope very well. It's a very Western style story. It just so happens to have anime style art inside of it.
So you guys are starting as novel. Are you going to stay in that genre, or do you want to like move towards comics and mangas? Are there any plans to expand outside novels?
So we've been getting a lot of requests for making a manga, and that's right now on our top of our list of things to do. Right now we're searching for a manga artist to take care of that sort of thing, but it's really hard to find a consistent artist who is at the level of skill that we require to be hired for our works. Because we place an emphasis on aesthetics. Everything starts off with aesthetics for us. So we want to make sure that that stays as a consistent level of quality throughout all our works. That way people can see Novel Horizons, understand that you're getting a high quality product, not just in the story, but in the visuals and in the editing.
So when it comes to a process from beginning to pretty much end to publishing, what can hopeful writers expect when they send in their transcript and they want to work their way to publishing?
So once a manuscript is submitted, let's say hypothetically we accept the manuscript for publishing, we do the contract work, you know, everything gets signed, all that legal stuff gets out of the way. After that, what we end up doing is we start doing a developmental pass on the manuscript, where we read through it and we see where there could be a little bit of alteration done. Not like huge story things, but like pacing, or maybe sometimes your character falls out of character because as a writer, sometimes you can't create the voice of the character consistently the whole time. Just small things like that. And then we make sure there's a good beginning, climax, and end for volume. Because light novels are a serialization, volume 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We want to make sure each volume is self-contained to an extent. After that, we get our finalized draft, and we start looking for an author or an artist that can properly create an artwork that the author is happy with and that we're happy with. And we have the author choose major moments in that volume to choose for illustrations. So each of our books have at least 8 illustrations, so that gives you a good amount of 8 major moments inside that one book that you can choose to create a visual for. And then we go through, we set that aside in the manuscript, and we have the artist get to work on that. And then we're communicating with the author this whole time. We get a sketch, we send it to the author, and we're like, what do you think of this? Or these are what the characters imagining look like. At the same time, we're doing character designs for the cast, because we take care of what the characters look like. So the author tells us, oh, this is a 5'6" female with brown hair and blue eyes. She wears this kind of clothes. We send that brief to our character designers. They start sending us different passes, like 10 to 12 different visualizations, and the author kind of chooses their favorite from that. Kind of Legos until we get the final product. Artwork aside, once the finalized draft is there, we send it to our editing team. The editing team takes care of all the grammatical problems, and then we get a edit manuscript where we have the original, and then the edits are in red. So we send that to the author, and it's like, so these are the changes the editor made. Which ones do you like? Which ones the editor kind of misunderstood? And we do that a few times until we get our final finished manuscript, and then we kind of put it all together. And there's a few more passes after that, but...
Or just a gist of it.
Yeah, as a general.
Okay. So what you said that you guys should do a novelization, like full-blown volume. Can someone submit a one-shot story? Like, would you accept one-shot stories?
That's not something we're specifically looking for, but if it's a good one-shot, we can definitely accept it. Like, this series right here, this is our Romance Slice of Life. It's a mini-series, so it's only going to have 3 volumes. So it's going to be, once it's there, it's done. But the rest of these are technically designed to run on a little bit longer. This one I designed to be 5. And with that in mind, if it's a one-shot and it's like a fully complete story, as long as it fits within like the light novel realm, then we can definitely, we don't see any reason why we wouldn't do it.
You mentioned working with the author and coming to the story. If the author doesn't have a specific end in mind, do you guys work with them to come up with an end, or how they can tell their story?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you just give them that freedom to like, however you end it, you end it?
So we try to, when working with artists and authors, we try to be as offhand as possible. That way we don't stifle their creativity. Because if there's someone looming over you trying to tell you like what to do or how to do something, they end up kind of losing their motivation and kind of become suffocating. I've worked with creatives for a while, so I can kind of see how they kind of get burned out faster when you do stuff like that. So if the author comes with no specific ending in mind, as long as the volumes are consistent and there's like, you know, they're good reads across, we can kind of let them figure it out as they go along. Because that's a way to write a story. Some people like to write beginning, middle, and end and just fill it in. Some people like to start and then just kind of figure it out as they go on. So we like to be pretty flexible with that.
So I'm sure a lot of artists and writers are probably wondering, monetization, how like, does that work? I know it's all contract, but like, is it like we have a budget of, your story's created for 5 volumes. So we give you a budget for those 5 volumes, or do you do it by how much the book sells, or how does the contract work for that?
We do royalty deals. So we can't really disclose the exact, you know, prices of the royalty deals, but the authors make money based on how many of their copies sell. And that's determined, and those royalties kick in after the initial investment is covered. So let's say an author submitted their manuscript and it cost us $10,000 to turn it into a book, which is pretty average cost. After that, we would open up pre-sales, and those pre-sales would have to hit $10,000 before we start giving the author their royalty. So right, so far we haven't really had a problem with hitting our investment back. So all our books so far have pre-sold for the amount we've invested so that we can start giving royalties out. So sometimes authors are just like, oh, what if my book doesn't sell enough to make up for the pre-sales? Will I have to pay you guys back the amount of money you invested? It's like, no, we take care, we front the full cost and then we deal with whatever debt is left over. So if anything, just motivates us to want to sell it more. So the author doesn't have to worry about having to pay us any debts or anything in terms of that. But their royalty does not kick in until that initial investment is covered.
So marketing wise, do you work with the author on how they want their books to be marketed, or you have your own department that figures all of that stuff out?
We take care of all the marketing. As far as the author's involvement in the process goes, they do the manuscript, and then we make sure that the manuscript stays faithful throughout the refinement process. And then we take their opinions on the artwork, and then where to put the artwork. But as far as marketing goes, we kind of take care of that. And then the author's allowed to do their own like independent marketing. Like Peter for the romance story, he has his own social medias and he likes talking about his book on there. And he's just like, oh yeah, you know, and this is where you can go get it and things like that. So, but the major marketing, the overall stuff is taken care of by us. But there's no specific, you can't market your own book clause.
So one of my last questions, earlier you were talking about giving the artist freedom. What are some of the restrictions that you guys like, you can't cross certain lines?
In terms of topic?
In terms of the book, themes, or...
There's, like, the 18 plus line, you know, that sort of thing. Because once we start getting into 18 plus territory, we sort of have to, like, tiptoe how we sell it. Because a lot of convention booths don't allow that sort of thing normally. So we try to stick with the 13, 6, 18 age range sort of thing, young adult. But as far as topic goes, we've had some pretty dark submissions. And there's, you know, some pretty dark topics that are discussed in some of them. So it really goes on a case-by-case basis. Same thing with the illustrations. Like, we're willing to look into them. Like, we try to keep an open mind about them. But we'd have to also talk about amongst ourselves, like in the company, about what kind of special treatment and what kind of restrictions when it comes to selling, like what kind of warnings we would have to put on, things like that. So as far as lines that we don't cross, it's a pretty, I wouldn't say, I don't want to say that there isn't any, because there are some, like within the bound of common sense, but we try to be as open as possible.
So you don't, so you allow adult stories, it just has to, it's just a gap that you don't want to cross when it comes to...
We just need to know it's an adult story, that way we can market it as an adult story, and that we are capable of being able to card people whenever they want to look at it.
Right.
So we can follow the basic rules that need to be followed for stuff like that, like for 18 plus, 21 plus works.